Rated R.
Yeah, I just don't know how, like, the frame rate would be on a actual security camera. And it has to be a USB camera, so it has to be USB camera, night vision, hopefully waterproof. But I'm more concerned with the frame rate. I want it to look like it looks in real life. I don't want it to be like images of the train going like this, all stuttering. RIP headphone users, sorry guys. It's a little bit loud on the outside of the train, but it's real life. Yeah, bar party time, it is definitely a cold train. Fully loaded, headed downhill. Beautiful scenery though, I love it. Love the trees. Trees move in the wind when it's windy outside. The textures are all affected by weather, which is pretty cool. You hear the squeal on the track. Really, really liking this new game, except for that screen tear. Don't like the screen tear. Other than that, the game's really good. All right, let's get back inside so it's a little bit quieter for you guys. Let me put that away for now. I don't see any sun out there. And of course, as the sun glare comes into view, right? Mostly USB. All right, Smoke Eater, I'm gonna check it out. Might need to go to like Alltex or look on Amazon then. ACS, I am drinking some Maker's Mark. Big shout out to my sponsor, Maker's Mark out there, for hooking me up. As I shake my head no, because that's a complete lie. Sorry guys. I'm just dreaming in my head. Yep, we actually got a green light for once. So the train in front of us is at least a signal ahead. Alright, noobs. Take care, man. Definitely appreciate you hanging out with us. Everybody say, see ya, noobs. Give them a shout out. Long time viewer right there. Do they actually have an adapter like from the yellow to red to like the CCTV cameras to USB? I didn't think that was actually possible. Could be wrong. So we got about 2-3 miles to go before our increase in speed. We'll be able to get to about 50 miles per hour. It's definitely on the fast section. I'll show you guys, we're towards the end of the tight section of the mountain. Once we get to this area, we'll be able to definitely speed up and we'll count down the miles to Cumberland Terminal. And it will slow down right towards the actual terminal, a couple miles out. And we'll go really, really slowly actually into the terminal, but you'll see that 12-mile marker right here click down as we hit that straightaway. No, hunting camera is like the worst frame rate possible, Chris, I'm pretty sure. That's like a frame per minute. I'm sure there's better ones than that nowadays, but the ones I've seen are pretty horrible. Although it would get like a nice picture of the train going by. I just want it to be like real life. Like, hey, switching to train cam now, taking a train shot. As you see the train going by, you guys can call it what it is. That'd be my hope. Oh, what up, Meteor? Yeah, yeah, I remember CSX1234. And I hate the Cursed Forest. That was a scary game. I hate horror games in general, but that one had a lot of jump scares in it for sure. But yeah, I remember that. I don't remember the lightning strike scaring me offhand, but everything else in that game definitely did. So I was on edge, man. Can't help it. I need to get Bri-Bri or Bri-Bri over here to do some more of the train sim, horror, and then farm sim at some point. All right, Smoke Eater, let me just climb out of the cab real quick. I'm going to wash it for you real fast. Actually, I think I could probably walk outside if I really wanted to. I'm just afraid of speeding. All right, got a mile to go before we can crank it up to 50 miles per hour. Although, we do have to keep in mind that the back of the train has to clear that marker before we can actually go that fast. And it is 6:33 p.m. local time, which is really funny because it's actually 6:36 here at my house, so it's like real life. The sun's going down. Kind of crazy. Yeah, Wipeout, you can. Let me, next time I break, I'll get up real quick and show you. I don't know if you, I guess you can control the train, not in the engineer seat. I'm not 100% sure. I really don't want to try it, because I don't want to jack up the scenario for YouTube, but let me break real quick and then I'll show you. So yeah, you can like literally get up. Let me see if I can actually change my settings real quick. No, so I can't control how fast I'm going walking around. I have to be in the engineer's seat. Yeah, you could technically get up and walk around like you want to, but you cannot adjust the settings on the train when you're walking around. So I guess that's pretty important when you think about multiplayer aspect. Like, literally, you could switch seats with someone you're streaming with. They could take over halfway while you go over there and relax and drink if you wanted to, which by far is the best idea ever. If DTG can actually implement multiplayer in this game, I'd be pretty excited. And I know it's coming, I just don't know when it's actually coming. Actually, they almost fixed it, Meteora. They're going through a bunch of beta testing right now. Right now, it's 100 times better than what it was, I'll tell you that much. The horn a little too early for how fast I'm going. That's fine though. It'll hold us a really long time. I'm gonna be that annoying train driver at night, smoking meth, just holding the horn down, waking everybody up. Should be on. Brake release, yeah, brake pressure's at zero. Get the side view real quick. Another intersection coming up, going through the town here. Actually, multiple intersections from the look of it. Start playing tug of war with the guy in the rear. See, this is all stuff that would be possible in multiplayer. By fall 2017. What up, Master Gaming? Welcome to the stream again. I really, really hope they implement it sooner than later. That'd be awesome. I'd love to stream with some of you guys while playing this. All right, we just got cleared to 50 miles per hour. Just gonna get back in cab. Let's take off the dynamic brake real quick. And let's get going. The leave it at Knott Street for just a second until we get up to power. It's going to do notch 4. And 50 miles per hour is going to feel like we're literally flying this game. I got the speed down really, really well. Notch 5. It would have to be a closed lobby, yeah, otherwise there'd be trolls everywhere. I'm down for that. Anybody who wanted to play, including you, Wipeout, I'll definitely let on. Even if we had like 6 people just riding along on the train, I'm down for that too. I'm gonna do a runaway train scenario. Set up dynamic brake again. Alright, you can see we're actually ticking down the miles now. We got 10 miles to go. We're almost heading directly towards Cumberland Terminal. So you'll definitely see that ticket down here shortly as we make some good time. Just need to watch out for whenever the speed starts reducing a little bit. Let the horses loose. Oh yeah. Looks like I got up to power pretty quick. Take a look on the exterior as we get going. Sorry for the headphone users out there. Now it gets a little bit louder on the exterior. And what time is it? 6:40 p.m. in game time. Literally feels like you're flying in the game, only doing 46 miles per hour. It's pretty cool. Let's look at the frame rate real quick. 30 frames a second, not bad. Much better than the 15-20 I would get before, so they're definitely working on it. Let's get back inside because I know it's really, really loud out there. Ooh, 12:45 Wipeout, Jesus. Still got over 31 viewers on YouTube and Twitch. Thank you everybody for watching, definitely appreciate it. I do 16 CJ, I have GTA 5 for PS3 only actually. I'm the one of the rare people who didn't get it for PS4 or for PC as of yet. About 9 miles to go. Comfortable 46 miles per hour. I'm gonna go ahead and leave it as is on the dynamic brake. Keep us right here if we can. I don't know, Wipeout. Isn't the 1060 really good? Pretty sure your 1060 is better than my Titan, isn't it? Maybe I'm wrong. Eight miles to go. Still cleared for 50 miles per hour for a while, so I'm happy with that. I want to be this guy in real life, like just chilling out, making sure I don't have a heart attack, sun's mostly down, as far as I can tell. I don't know, I have one of the original Titans, so whatever that is, I think it's 6'8", somewhere in there. Yeah, I got the old-ass Titan Wipeout. In fact, it was one of the only cards that had a problem during the initial beta of this game and, like, two other games. It really gave me a problem on Ghost Recon Wildlands. It was the only card that they had, like, a known issue for during the beta where you couldn't start it up properly. I forgot what it was, but I eventually got it working. I'm going to reduce dynamic brake just a little bit. Try to pick up a mile or two per hour if I can. There you go, slowly ticking back up. Another intersection coming up. Go. A couple more intersections coming up from the looks of it. Alright, so yeah, hit me up, man. My name for PSN should be below on the description if you want to. It should be Black and Red GT. So feel free to hit me up on there. I don't know if I'll be on PS3 in time today or tomorrow, but maybe throughout the week I'll be on there. Really been on Xbox One a lot lately, playing certain games. In fact, I need to live stream Braid doing the speed run for you guys as well. It's one thing I haven't done. Still clear for 50, got 6 miles to go. I should see a speed reduction coming up sometime soon. Smokey Eater, are we there yet? We're getting there, man. Definitely getting there. It's a long scenario, though. Probably about 2.5 hours in total. I need to upgrade my Titan. If any guys want to buy my Titan, then let me know. I'll sell it for cheap. Although I think Bree would probably end up buying it more than likely. Is that an intersection? I can't tell. Nope. A little fueling station or something. I don't know what that was. Lots of good scenery on this though. We're getting to more populated areas as we go down the hill. Oof. It was sick and got some testing coming up. That sucks. Meteor. Alright, we should definitely be slowing down here fairly soon. There we go, 2 miles. Gotta get down to 35 miles per hour from the looks of it. Actually, 1 mile now. Basically almost down to 35 as is right now. We'll take dynamic brake off. We'll get back inside the cab because I'm going to have to speed up, it looks like. We're starting to go slightly uphill. Excuse me, guys. Definitely hear the engines winding up. Down to 35 miles per hour and under. Going slightly downhill. Let it coast and see if I'm picking up speed or not real quick. 3 miles to go into Cumberland Terminal from the looks of it. Going down a slight decline from the looks of it. It's almost 7 p.m. at night. The sun's almost all the way down. We need to definitely hurry up and get into the yard. Okay, 2 miles to go. Bit of brakes as we go down. Looks like we have to get down to 25 coming up as well as we get closer to the terminal. All right, CJ, appreciate it, man. I'll definitely add you as soon as possible. we've got about 1 mile to go before the reduction in speed. I'm waiting for it to start ticking off the amount of yards, though. There we go. It's ticking off. Oh, it's got a reward, driven 100 miles. Stay in cab for just a little bit so I don't mess this up. Slow down just a little too much. DDR3 is definitely the way to go, just so you guys know. What up, VA Merc? How's it going, man? Welcome to the stream. Nice to see you again. Let's see where we're actually at on the map real quick. So we started up here, all the way down here by the yard in our goal, so we're getting really, really close. Again, we're playing the Cumberland Charge scenario, in case you guys are wondering, for those who are just tuning in. Definitely starting to get darker now. About to be, what, 7 p.m. in game from the looks of it. Yeah, V8 Merc, I heard the beta 3 is out now to improve frame rate. The frame rate's actually doing really good right now. Well, I should say that I'm only getting 25 FPS right now. But I did another scenario and I was getting right at like 50 frames per second. On the powering up part, I guess part one or point one, whatever it's called. So I do have hope that they're gonna fix the frame rate issues. They're definitely working on it. Normally I'd be getting like 15 right now. So the fact that I'm actually getting 25 is pretty good. I'm getting about 7 to 8 at a minimum more frames per second right now, just with the small update that they did. What up, Sand? How's it going, man? Yeah, we got 19 people on Twitch, and we got, I think, 15. I can't read that fast enough. We got 15 on YouTube or Twitch and 19 on the other. Keep in mind, we are doing a free game giveaway at the end of the scenario. We're almost there, probably another 10 to 15 minutes at the most. So you guys are welcome to hang out, win some free video games if you want to. Then we're going to start playing probably some Train Simulator Mechanic for a little bit before ending the live stream. I think we're about 1 mile to 2 miles out from the terminal right now. Yep, just about 1 mile out from the terminal. Man. Still coughing from when I was sick like 4 weeks ago, 5 weeks ago. It's crazy. That's what I get for not going to the doctor sooner, though. Yeah, DTG is definitely working on the updates. I'm super surprised, honestly, but also happy at the same time.
Don't you know?